The next thing I'm going to show you is the master volume fader. The master volume fader can be assigned to any type of bus or any type of master volume. If you have some, if you have all your tracks within your track going to analog 1-2 as the outputs, what's going to happen if you make a master track fader for the analog 1-2, it's going to control every single track that goes to 1-2. So it's kind of like cutting everything off at the last second and just putting a fader there so you can affect them all. With this one, you can also add automation, different things like that, as far as like putting fades at the end of songs and turning the volume down, things like that. It's very helpful. So just go to the master one, and you can look at it, and it's just the volume. The volume you can change by using either the draw tool or the hand tool. The hand tool, you can actually, if you put it on grid, you can grab it from a certain bar and change it and actually do a bar, make sure your bars are perfect and your fades are perfect. You could also do different drawing things, like you can do freehand with this pencil tool to draw in your volume and draw in your fades. You can also change different automations and things like that if you want within the track. If there's like parts that get a little too loud, you can just kind of dip them a little bit, and you can actually turn parts up a little bit at certain parts.